afternoon, everybody. As she did introduce me, my name is Jehovahnie. I recently moved at KCISEC as the Vice PE Coordinator. I come from Shanghai, pretty much have been in China for 10 years. I came here when I was 17 years old. It's strange, but living right after high school, and the first country where my parents decided to send me is China. A place with me not having knowledge of what I'm supposed to be, where I'm supposed to go, with who I'm supposed to be, I was here sent alone. Honestly speaking, it wasn't easy the first 6 months in China for me. It was a most interesting and the most difficult part of my life as a teenager, 17 years old. The only reason I came through and actually made it through the age of 17 to 28 now, working at KCIS, is because I have a strong mindset. Where does the strong mindset come from? As I said, I'm very passionate about sports. I do sports a lot, I do exercise a lot. And today's topic at TED is pretty much the gap not seen between education and sports, what sports can actually teach you. And I'm here actually to share my story with you, and we all maybe gonna come to an understanding of the value of sports in each student's life. As a basketball player, I played back home from the age of 14 years old. I started playing basketball, but before basketball, I was doing athleticism. The condition when we were practicing actually was not adequate for the sport. But nevertheless, we don't quit. No matter what, raining, sunny, you have to go to training. We didn't have the facility or the ability to get the expensive shoes or the proper shoes to actually practice how to run on the track field, which was difficult. And every time I was going through those periods, I was always questioning myself, should I quit? Because my parents actually don't care whether I'm doing sports. And my parents wouldn't pay for tuition fees or pay for anything for me to get involved into sport activities. Then me speaking into sport was for myself, not for my parents, not for whoever was watching me. It was because I liked to do it and I enjoyed doing it. And I loved the benefits that I was getting from sport. Sport taught me a lot of life skills, which is the skills that I would never learn, I would have never learned in classroom. Never quit. In classroom, if I'm doing a math test or physics test or English test, if it's difficult for me, I mean, we do the same thing. You will stop doing it because you're tired of studying it. But in sports, when I was on the field, when I was running track, I had to finish. There's somebody in front of me. You cannot quit. You have to finish down the line. Whether you come first or last, you have to finish. After moving from sport to athleticism, I switched sports, went to basketball. Athleticism was very difficult. You have to run and get tired. Nevertheless, basketball is not easy here. I start practicing basketball, I start getting better at it, start playing for the team in my city. That was fun. I wanted more. I wanted to go more above, travel, do the most like everybody wants in life when they do sports. Which was not an option for me. My parents wouldn't spend money on any activity. My parents didn't have the luxury to pay for a coach to teach me how to play the sport. I didn't walk to go to practice, I was taking a car, maybe, but I didn't have the parental support that I needed to continue doing sport. Nevertheless, did not quit. Through the time of learning, 15 years old, 16 years old, 17 years old, I graduated from my high school and I'm sent to China. I wanted to continue playing basketball, but it was very difficult here as a foreigner because there's the rule of no more than two foreigners per team. And as well, in order to make it through, you need to come from women NBA or WNBA or something, which was not the case for me. I'm from Cameroon. We don't have any women NBA coming up. I kept playing the sport, make my connection through learn the culture, learn the language, met new people, met friends, joined tournaments. It was very fun. And I came in China studying aviation. And I'm pretty sure that all of you are asking themselves, how come did I end up in sports when I have my degree in aviation? I studied at Northwestern Polytechnical University in Xi'an. I studied at Northwestern Polytechnical University in Xi'an in aeronautical. I graduated in 2015, and that was the first year for China to actually make foreigners and Chinese study together in English, which was quite difficult. Me coming speaking French, not much in English, I don't know Chinese. My English was getting there as well, and I'm studying with Chinese students as well who's having the same problem. So we all have the common goal. We all have the common goal of struggling with English as a second language. English as a second language for me, English as a second language for Chinese classmates. Moving along, after my graduation, I've decided not to continue in aeronautical. It was very difficult. In the term of getting the job or getting internship, even in China, in such subject, because aviation, it's not finance. It involves more than just study. It involves politics, it involves security matters, which was very difficult for foreigners to find a job in China in aviation. Then I went back home. I did an internship for 2 months. Honestly speaking, I didn't like it. It was boring. It was not creative. I studied all these years trying to make changes in everything I do. But I'm working in an internship and they tell me I don't have to change anything. All I have to do is make sure the numbers are correct, make sure this number shows every time. If there's a problem, then we need to call somebody else to fix it, which becomes boring and then for me, then I switch and I decide, why don't I follow what I love?
Something that I love doing without any problem. Something that I could do without feeling tired. Something that I would enjoy doing. Then I continue
pursuing what I love the most, which is sports. And me doing basketball, with all the experience and all the doors that I got open with the classmates that I met, I went through it. Long term short, I did my master's degree in sports management, which I'm actually currently still studying. I was coaching youth basketball in Shanghai. I got the opportunity to coach from a French coach, actually, who was in China, living in Shanghai, that gave me the job. So I say, studying aeronautical was very difficult, but basketball or sports being my passion got me into this. I got that energy from working because I've seen people change. I've seen people changing their mindset. I've seen people changing the way they feel about certain subjects or certain things through sports. That energy I was getting from the people outside actually kept me moving. I continue pursuing sports. Nevertheless, with a low salary, I didn't stop coaching. Because I was not walking because I want the money. I was walking because I enjoyed doing what I was doing. As you can see me on the court, if you did have an opportunity to watch the United Games, I'm very vocal. I shout a lot. I'm so passionate. Sometimes the referee will confuse my passion with anger. But I'm not angry. I'm just too passionate that I want to let that energy go out to everybody. If you're passionate about something, don't let someone stop you from it. Don't hide your passion. Don't hide how motivated or emotional or how you feel, you get impacted by certain things. You shouldn't hide it. Which is where the gaps come from. As a parent, sometimes parents fail to see the necessity or the needs of your love for the sport that you're doing. Which is true, they want you to go to school, they want you to get the degree. diploma, they want you to study, they want you to pass that math test. Nevertheless, when you will go look for a job, nobody's going to ask you what is the cosinus of one. But they will ask you, what experience do you have? What life experience do you have? True internship, we get those experiences, true. But in school, nobody teaches you how to interact with other people, how to deal with other people's feelings. As a human, we need to connect. Sports taught me how to be friends with people. Sports taught me how to mind my business. Because when you're competing, you're not competing against somebody else, you're competing against yourself. Sport taught me how to push myself beyond the limits, how to know to challenge myself. Every time it's hard, you don't quit. You continue, you give your best. Sport taught me one thing the most, how to be confident. No matter what, no matter where I am, I'm able to step in the room and say I'm the best. Even if I'm the last in the exam, I will tell all of you I'm the best. Because I'm confident. And that's what you need to understand by doing sport. Don't be afraid of joining any sport. Whether it's frisbee, basketball, volleyball, soccer, get into the team. Get involved with so many different activities. Find the balance between sport and education. You need to. Both goes along. But it's very difficult for somebody who do not do the sport to understand that gap. We will fail to see that from my side, if I put 6 and 9 on the opposite side, from this side I will see 6, on the opposite side I will see 9. But the person that is standing on the opposite side will see 6 and 9. But the only way for both of us to see the same number is if we make one step to another. It needs to walk halfway and I need to meet halfway. I'm going to share an example. Now, it's a true story that actually happened. In the U19 team, I do have students with a low GPA. Very low. Their parents fail to get them motivated into class. They don't want to pass the class. They don't care about the subject. They just want to play basketball, which I totally understand. Now it comes to me as a coach to make them understand the need of basketball at the school. Because when, as I say, when you're going to look for a job, nobody's going to ask you how to draw a line. Nobody will tell you what's the algebra's formula. Nobody's going to ask you those type of questions. All they want you to know is to have a diploma, to show your ability to learn something. That's why you need your degree. Now, going back to the story, I sat the student down and I explained to him, if your GPA do not go by 3 at the end of this semester, next semester you can consider yourself out of the team. You're my best player, but that's not a problem for me. I care more about your future than the present right now. Now you're going to be helpful at KCISEC, winning the games and everything, but what about tomorrow? What about if tomorrow you're not able to be a professional basketball player, you break your leg? You need a job. Who's going to give you a job? You're not going to be mama's father, mama and papa on charge. You have to find a job for yourself. Which was very difficult to make him understand until during every basketball class I was having with him, he was studying. He understood the needs of passing his class at the basketball team. So now, if both of us didn't come to the agreement that we need to actually work towards education and sports for him to be a passionate good thing, he wouldn't come to the understanding, he wouldn't come to the conclusion of actually making his GPA getting high. Now he's sitting on a GPA of 2.9. We are not there yet at the end of the semester, but he moved from 2.1 to 2.9. That's the gap. Between education and basketball, for example. We fail to understand that we love the sport as much as we love the sport, we still need a diploma. There's only one LeBron James. There's only one Curry. Don't try to be somebody you are not. Always try to be the best version of yourself. Thank you.